My name is Chester Brown from Grenada. I used to be on the Carronage, hanging, diving tourist boat, playing guitar. When I resign from that, I go out, start sailing on ships like the Cunard, Sun Viking. I work on tankers, I work with the Windjammer Company. Well, my lifestyle was sailing is just like, you know, running plenty girls, living bad life, you know, just doing things. I enjoy it. Well, I'm married. I got 6 children. I got 4 in St. Vincent and 2 in Grenada. I have grand. I have about 4 to 5 grand. My queen was from Guam, and she came to St. George's, and she had a family. We was very interested. She had children abroad, even in Trinidad, you know. And then I lived some life in Trinidad, too. Well, I used to work with my uncle in a hardware store that was down sour, which they call the Quasi, you know, and was nice. Well, I attended GBSS, but wasn't for long because I was kind of horrible, you know, very miserable, always in a gang fighting, doing, you know, but not stealing. Well, I had plenty of friends, but I never had, they say, like bad boys friends. I had friends, you know, who was educated, so I hung around good friends and stay away from the bad ones. Well, I spent about, they say, about 10 years, from primary to secondary. The best memory in school, I remember when me and the teacher had get away and he flogged me and I couldn't take it and I pulled a chair and I hit him and then they keep me away from school for a couple of weeks and take me back. I didn't regret. Well, I didn't have no thinking about ambition. My best choice was sailing and my sailing life was chef. I like to do cooking. Well, I went to places like Miami, Nassau, Panama, Colombia, Santo Domingo. Well, I sailed the whole of the Caribbean, the whole complete Caribbean. Well, I came here with a boat with a gentleman they call Mr. McFarlane, which his nickname is Dada. He lived at Belgium and was very, very experienced with him that I just decided I love this country here and I just decided to stay and make here my home. I didn't have no problem living here and I'm living comfortable and the people here is living nice with me, and I live nice with people. I don't get myself in trouble. Everyone know me. When I wake in the morning, first thing I scrub my mouth, take a shower, drink a cup of tea, and I head for the town. Well, I'm not working anyway, but sometimes I do a little panquai off and on. But during the day while I am in town, I just drink it whole day, having a good time. When I get tipsy, dance down the place until evening, I go home. To describe myself, I'm drinking, I like my alcohol, and I just like to be the way how I live it. I decide to change my life in a future to come, but I don't think in a hurry right now because to change my life right now, being living batchy, I will feel uncomfortable. They usually come up here, pay me a visit off and on, give me a change, whatever they give me a content, buy food, but yet still, you know, I'm going to buy a little drink out of it. You know, I'm not leaving all that. Drinking keeps me motivated every day. Every day I must take a drink. My favorite place to live is by the tourist bureau. I get away with the taxi driver. Well, it's closer to the port, and I see when the foreigners come in. I know some of them. So it's a better place to live than out at district. My best friend is like men who drink cigarettes with me. Well, the favorite time of year is Carnival, because there's where the liquor is and music. Because I like to do a lot of dancing. Well, I like plenty. My best music is calypso. Well, right now, my favorite song, as I say, every time I hear that song, even though I sit there, I gotta get up and shake. La la la. Baby, no, baby, no. You mean they throw my clothes in the garbage? It's the best song I ever. Serious. Well, if I had to change my life to be changed, you know, I would like to go back on the sea, go back sailing. The only help I need right now is a little house so I could own that. Because right now where I'm living is not mine, but I'm living free. I'm still thanking the Almighty to give the lady health and strength who gives me the property to stay. And I wish her all the best that she helped me out. By the end of the year, the only thing I'd like to achieve is a vehicle. Because the distance where I'm living is a rough toss. Knowing I'm not working, transportation here is kind of expensive. So even I have a little scooter, I could be moving up and down, you know, because no sense staying in the country, but the country have no money. I got to come in the city and look for the dingo dineros. A lady called Miss Swan, she usually go to the Catholic Church. Well, she look out for me a lot. Because when I done and out, I go to her and say, oh, Miss Swan, you know, you're a very nice lady. You know, I'm done and out. Could you give me some money? She said, well, you got to work for it. I said, I don't mind working for it. So thank you for all the best you have done for me.